Hello and welcome to azurewala YouTube channel. We are in part 28 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 56 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 57. You have an Azure subscription that contains a virtual network named VNet1 in East US 2 region. A network interface named VM1-NI is connected to VNet1. You successfully deploy the following Azure Resource Manager template. Let's see what template says. So from this template we can make sense that we have deployed one virtual machine which name was VM1. Its availability zone is 1. Its location is East US 2. And another thing is it has VM1 NI NIC card, network interface. And similarly, if we scroll down, we have another virtual machine which is name is VM2. Its availability zone is 2 and its location is East US 2. Its virtual network card name is VM2NI. Now the question, further we scroll down. For each of the following statements, select yes if the statement is true, otherwise select no. So we have answer area given and we have three statements given. So let's see the first statement. Virtual machine 1 and virtual machine 2 can connect to VNet1, yes or no. Let's try to understand statement 1 from this diagram, that we have virtual machine 1 in availability zone 1 and VM2 is in availability zone 2, and definitely VNet is in all these zones. So keep in mind that virtual network and availability zone, how they relate to each other is that virtual networks and subnets span all availability zones in a region. We don't have to divide them by availability zone to accommodate zonal resources. Therefore VNet is available in zone 2, zone 1 and zone 3 as well, and whatever the virtual machines running in zone 2 and zone 1 can connect to VNet, therefore they can connect to each other as well. So let's prove this theory in Azure portal. We have resource group 1. In resource group 1 we have one virtual network which is in East US region, and we'll try to create one virtual machine to prove the theory. So we are in resource group 1 and we'll go and give the name VM1 for example, and here we'll go. So we are in the same region, East US, and if we select the availability zone here, it will give us three options, that our virtual machine is going to be in zone 1, zone 2 or zone 3. So if we select the zone 1, we can connect it to virtual network 1. So let's see in networking tab. So in networking tab, virtual network 1 is available. It is showing here. It means we can easily connect it with VNet1. Similarly, if I go back and I select the zone 2 and I go back to networking tab again, I can see that virtual network 1 is available here. It means for virtual network 1 is available for zone 1, zone 2 and probably zone 3 as well. That proves that all the virtual machine in different zone can communicate with virtual network, and in turn they can communicate with each other as well. Further, if I go to the region and if I change the region to, for example, West US, and I select go to networking tab, I can see here that I cannot see the virtual network or VNet 1 here. It means it cannot connect to that virtual network that was in East US. So region to region connectivity of the virtual network is not there, but zone to zone connectivity is available. Therefore, for this virtual machine and virtual machine 2 can connect to VNet 1, statement or answer would be yes. Since the virtual machine 1 is in zone 1 and virtual machine 2 is in zone 2 in same region. Let's see next question. If an Azure data center becomes unavailable, VM1, VM2 will be available. So back to our Azure portal, we have selected availability zone here, means it's going to keep three copies of our virtual machine. So one copy would remain active and other copies would be the secondary copies. If we would have selected no infrastructure redundancy, that means it would only and only create one copy. So if we select the availability zone, we get three options here, that zone 1, zone 2 and zone 3. So where would you like to implement your first copy? Again, we would see in Microsoft.com the availability zones. Availability zones expand the level of control you have to maintain the availability of applications and data on your virtual machines. An availability zone is physical separate zone with an Azure region. There are three availability zones per supported Azure region. So this is very important. There are three copies each time. Each availability zone has distinct power source, network and cooling. By designing your solution to use replicated virtual machine in zones, you can protect your apps and data from the loss of data center. If one zone is compromised, then replicated apps and data are instantly available in another zone. Since we have implemented virtual machine 1 in zone 1 and VM2 in zone 2, so they do have separate copies in each zone, and they are going to get up when there is any compromise on the current copy. So definitely they are going to be available on other zone. So this statement or answer is yes, because these will be available if any of data center becomes unavailable. Let's see next statement. If East US 2 region becomes unavailable, virtual machine 1 and virtual machine 2 will be available. Definitely not, because they do have replication in zone and zones are residing in the same region. So entire region is getting down or it is unavailable. It means all of three zones would be unavailable. Therefore, any of the virtual machine will not be available. So for option 1, it was yes. Option 2, it was, or rather statement 1, it was yes. Statement 2, it was yes. And statement 3, it is no. I hope I was able to explain this question properly and answer it. So if you like the video, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell notification icon to receive the notification. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.